So welcome, Thomas Haring, President, Hexagon Geosystems and CEO Leica Geosystems, part of Hexagon. Great to have you here. So how are you and how is the feeling right now after 1 year forced break due to Corona?
Thanks, Denise. It's great to be at the InterGeo back. It's really, it's my 18th InterGeo. Wow. And I really missed it. So it's much more than an exhibition or conference. Okay. It's meeting the community, and that's what I enjoy.
That's interesting. It's my 10th InterGeo this year. Yeah. So, okay. So, Thomas, but you're celebrating around birthday this year with Hexagon. Namely, it's 100 years of innovation in Heerbrugg. And therefore, I would like to briefly explain what Heerbrugg is to our visitors, if you don't know. Heerbrugg is located in Switzerland and is the headquarter of Leica Geosystems and Hexagon Geospatial, and is an essential component of the Hexagon Technology Group. And you started exactly a century ago in 1921 as Heinrich Wild Werkstätte für Feinmechanik und Optik. And Heerbrugg was repeatedly been the source of a major innovations. So we'll have a look at this 100-year history of innovation. So, Thomas, usually success stories of technology or innovation companies start in a garage or a shed, for example, like Apple, Microsoft, mm-hmm. Bill Gates, and so on. So was it the same with the story of Heerbrugg?
Yeah, it was a small house. And that's, if you're coming to a book right now, you would see, because we put it on one of our buildings. And in Hannover, if you are at the InterGeo in Hannover, you could go outside in the outdoor field. And there we have built something up as well to show you a little bit how the house looked like when Heinrich Wild started back in 1921.
Yeah, this is great. And we also got some pictures of your booth and some video footage. This is why also our visitors right now can see the little shed there, how it started.
So this beautiful Heerbrugg, yes.
This is great. So. Your claim at InterGeo is 100 years of innovation from Heerbrugg. And so what role did innovation play in the company history? And what role does innovation play today?
That's, I think, in one sentence, very easy to answer. In the past, innovation was very important. When Heinrich Wild started, now it's essential. And we are known for innovation. And that innovation spirit is deeply entrenched in our organization. Mm-hmm. But maybe one comment on that. It was not Heinrich Wild alone. He was together with Robert Helbling and Jakob Schmidheiny. It was really a team which made it happen. Mm-hmm. I think that's something which we do today as well, developing things in a team, because we depend on all our people. And we're not celebrating 100 years Heerbrugg only. We are celebrating all the thousands of people worldwide which have been with us on the journey, which is not over, because the journey continues.
Yeah, and you help them with your technologies and made life easier and easier.
Correct,
to
and they help us to really further develop it.
Yeah, perfect. So can you give me examples of these game-changing innovations in the company history?
Maybe you can look at the T2, the famous T2, which was really setting grounds, foundation for modern surveying. Really a great optic mechanical total station theodolite at that time. And it was, I'm not sure how many years it was in the market, I have forgotten, many, many years. And you can come to our booth and see it live there. Yeah? And it's interesting, I had a discussion earlier this morning with somebody who said, I'm still using it for training some of my people.
Oh, really?
It was
That's fantastic.
Yeah. Our quality lasts forever. That's perfect.
That's a great example. So, looking back at the company history, which one is your favorite product and why?
I'm sure you understand that I really can't answer that.
Because of
I need
the
to be careful.
Huge amount of innovation.
And I, yes. No, but in general, I think it's important to look at the different technologies that we have further developed. Yeah? Total station technology, it's fantastic what we have done out of that from the roots dating back 100 years. GNSS over 40 years. Yeah? Where we have the GS18i, a fantastic product. We have radar technology, which is 20 years ago, and scanning technology, which we show in our booth as well, with fantastic new products, BLK ARC and BLK to fly. Mm-hmm. Yeah? And then maybe a smaller one, a personal thing, a small product, a Leica Lino L2, which is not such a famous product, but it was one product which we launched 16 years ago. A simple line laser, but with a really nice design. And that's something I think we have seen over so many years, how important design is in addition to technology. Mm-hmm.
Thank you very much for summarizing that. And you just mentioned some of the new technologies, the BLK ARC to go and to fly, we just already saw here at your booth. And you just looked a bit in the past and summarized this, but can you also get a glimpse of the future? So where's the company heading to?
Oh, if you would know, of course we know our strategy, our vision, our purpose, because we are as passionate as Heinrich Wild has been 100 years ago. We are heading towards a more autonomous future. And what does it mean? We are really trying to utilize the data. We are good in capturing data. We are good in preparing data for work, and we have more and more applications where we help the customers to put their data to work in all the different areas they are acting in, together with the customers, to solve their problems, whether it's surveying, whether it's other industries. Yeah? And we are interested to learn more about customer problems. So if somebody has an interesting application, interesting problem, where he needs support, please come to our booth, talk to the experts. Maybe don't talk to me, I'm not the expert of everything here, but I will find you the right person to talk to.
Okay, I think people will do so. We just mentioned in a sentence the BLK Arc to go. It's named like that, yeah. For me, it's the hidden champion, the social media star, because it's kind of a dog who's walking there, and I saw so many people taking their mobiles and making screenshots of it on photos, pictures, and I saw it on Instagram already. It's kind of a hidden champion, a little star.
Hopefully not a hidden champion, no. But you're absolutely right, it's really a superstar, and it's fantastic what the Leica BLK Arc does, yeah, and what kind of solution it now offers, yeah, that we have really a real reality capture device on top of the face famous Boston Dynamics spot. It's fantastic. But another superstar is the BLK to fly, the Leica BLK to fly. Mm-hmm. And unfortunately, we can't fly it at the booth inside. But I really would like everybody to ask for a demo that we can show you and how it really works. Because it's a flying sensor. It's not a UAV, it's a flying sensor. That's something we are very proud of as well, what the team achieved there. Fantastic,
great.
Yeah? It's always great to see this innovation coming out. Yeah, so.
Perfect.
And trust me, there's much more on the roadmap.
Okay. So Thomas, thank you very much for having you here in our Interview TV show and being part here of Interview 2021. And giving us these insights into 100 years of innovations made in Heerbrugg. So you are a company that combines traditional innovation in the best sense. So thank you very much for that.
Thanks a lot. We try to give our best. Yeah, and looking forward to the continuous discussions with our customers and, of course, with the InterGeo team. Thanks a lot.
Thank you very much. Enjoy InterGeo.
Thanks a lot. See you soon.